I'm Jaime Rivera with Pocketnow. We are at IFA in Berlin, and one of the major questions that I've read from the comments is, you're asking of what's gonna happen with this. This is the Samsung Galaxy Fold. It's not the two, this is actually the update to the original that I was able to play with for a couple of weeks recently. You've been asking what is going to change, what the company is going to improve, and it's about that time. Let's talk about it. Invited to a private room here at IFA in Berlin to be able to play with it and experience what it's like to have it once again. And I'll tell you this much, I mean, a lot of things have changed, a lot of things haven't really changed. First of all, the design is pretty much the same. Everything that we saw in the previous video is exactly untouched. From the outside, from the borders, from the build quality and the specifications, absolutely everything about this phone is the same. Also, the feel, for those of you that have liked that whole concept of being able to open a device and be able to use it as a tablet and close it to have a small display for typical day-to-day, this is exactly the same device. What has changed is actually mostly based on being able to make this product more durable. First of all, if you notice at the top and the bottom, we have new protective cups. This is actually to allow no debris to go into the mechanism, which is one of the issues that certain people experience with it. Also, we have a new flexible polymer that is being used under the bezel. If you remember in the past, the polymer was to a certain degree exposed and you could assume that it was a screen protector, and obviously we know how that ended up. The gap between the display and the hinge has also been removed. That's very hard to portray on camera, but it's not that the display is any slimmer or anything, it's just that there is, again, less of an opportunity for any debris to go into the hinge. Once again, this is all for the purpose of improving durability. Again, we had some experiences with it. I wasn't one of the people that had issues with the device, but the whole idea is for consumers to not be exposed to any sort of problems. The device is going to be launching tomorrow in Korea, followed by select countries, and you can actually expect a 5G variant to be part of that news. Now, for those of you wondering exactly what is going to happen with the United States, we still don't have a word on when it's going to launch. I actually don't know exactly when we're getting an updated review unit to be able to provide you with more content, but I'll tell you this much. So far, for the last couple of minutes that I've been playing with it, which is pretty much 30, it's been good. I've been opening and closing it multiple times. Everything seems to be working fine. Same One UI, same experience that's been enhanced to be able to use this product while opened and while closed. I do miss this device. I do wish that it was out and available to everyone. And obviously, we'll keep you posted as soon as we learn more. While you're at it, make sure you follow us on social media and subscribe to our channels, English and Spanish, for more videos like this one. And social media, follow us on Instagram, as our extended coverage of everything that's happening at IFA will be updated there. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I'm Jaime Rivera. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next one.